Thespia grandiflora is a tree in the Malvaceae family of the Rosids order. Its English common name is Maga. This tree is widely distributed throughout Puerto Rico, where it is endemic. It also is grown as an ornamental tree in Florida, Hawaii, Honduras, and in various Caribbean islands. The maga is used as an ornamental plant, but the wood of the tree itself is valued elsewhere for its durable timber. The flower of the tree, known as Flora de Maga, is the official national flower of Puerto Rico. The flower itself is very beautiful. It is sometimes called a hibiscus in English, although it belongs to a different genus and species from the true hibiscus and is more closely related to cotton. Thespesia. New Latin from Greek, feminine of thespesios, which is marvelous, divine, literally told by a god, akin to the Greek theos, god, and to enepien. Enepien means to tell or speak. The word thespian comes from the 1670s of or pertaining to tragedy or dramatic acting. From Greek thespis, who was a semi-legendary 6th century BC poet of Icaria in Attica, often called the father of Greek tragedy. The literal meaning of the name is inspired by the gods. Puerto Rico, which means rich port in Spanish. Puerto Ricans often call the island Boricuan, a derivation of Boriquen, its indigenous Taino name, which means land of the valiant lord. The terms Boricua or Boricano derive from Boriquen or Boriquen respectively, and are commonly used to identify someone of Puerto Rican heritage. The island is also popularly known in Spanish as La Isla del Encanto, meaning the island of enchantment. Columbus named the island San Juan Bautista in honor of Saint John the Baptist, while the capital city was named Ciudad de Puerto Rico, which means rich port city. Eventually, traders and other maritime visitors came to refer to the entire island as Puerto Rico, while San Juan became the name used for the main trading and shipping port and the capital city. The island's name was changed to Puerto Rico by the United States after the Treaty of Paris of 1898. The anglicized name was used by the U.S. government and private enterprises. The name was changed back to Puerto Rico by a joint resolution in Congress introduced by Felix Cordova Davila in 1931. The official name of the entity in Spanish is Estado Libre Asociado de Puerto Rico, the Free Associated State of Puerto Rico, while its official English name is Commonwealth of Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico means rich port in Spanish. Puerto Ricans often call the island Boricuan. Oh, it's a good thing I didn't read that. The Phrygian cap, or Liberty cap, is a soft conical cap with the apex bent over, associated in antiquity with several peoples in Eastern Europe and Anatolia, including Phrygia, Dacia, and the Balkans. In early modern Europe, it came to signify freedom and the pursuit of liberty through a confusion with the pileus, which is a cap of emancipated slaves of ancient Rome. In artistic representations, it signifies freedom and the pursuit of liberty. It is used in the coat of arms of certain republics or of republican state institutions in the place where otherwise a crown would be. It thus came to be identified as a symbol of the Republican form of government. A number of national personifications, in particular, France's Marianne, are commonly depicted wearing the Phrygian cap. France's Bonnet Rouge. In 1675, the anti-tax and anti-nobility stamp paper revolt erupted in Brittany and northwestern France, where it became known as the Bonnet Rouge Uprising after the blue and or red caps worn by the insurgents. Although the insurgents are not known to have preferred any particular style of cap, the name and color stuck as a symbol of revolt against the nobility and establishment. The use of a Phrygian-style cap as a symbol of revolutionary France is first documented in May 1790 at a festival in Troyes adorning a statue representing the nation at Lyon on a lance carried by the goddess Libertas. To this day, the national allegory of France, Marianne, is shown wearing a Phrygian cap. By wearing the bonnet rouge and sans culottes, without silk breeches, the Parisian working class made their revolutionary ardor and plebeian solidarity immediately recognizable. By mid-1791, these mocking fashion statements included the bonnet rouge as Parisian hairstyle, proclaimed by the Marquis de la Villette as the civic crown of the free man and French generation. On July 15, 1792, seeking to suppress the frivolity, François Christophe Kellermann, the first Duke de Vellemy, published an essay in which the Duke sought to establish the bonnet rouge as a sacred symbol that could be only worn by those with merit. The symbolic hairstyle became a rallying point and a way to mock the elaborate wigs of the aristocrats and the red caps of the bishops. On November 6, 1793, the Paris City Council declared it the official hairstyle of all its members. The bonnet rouge on a spear was proposed as a component of the national seal on September 22, 1792, during the third session of the National Convention. Following a suggestion by Jean Coulon, the convention decreed that convicts would not be permitted to wear the cap, as it was consecrated as the badge of citizenship and freedom. In 1792, when Louis XVI was induced to sign a constitution, popular prints of the king were doctored to show him wearing the bonnet rouge. The bust of Voltaire was crowned with the red bonnet of liberty. After a performance of his Brutus at the Comédie Française in March 1792. During the period of the Reign of Terror, September 1793 to July 1794, the cap was adopted defensively even by those who might be denounced as moderates or aristocrats, and were especially keen to advertise the adherence to the new regime. The caps were often knitted by women, known as tricolores, who sat beside the guillotine during public executions in Paris, and supposedly continued knitting in between executions. The spire of Strasbourg Cathedral was crowned in a bonnet rouge in order to prevent it from being torn down. Restoration in 1814, the Act de Déchets des Impurs Bonaparte's and restored the Bourbon regime, who in turn described the Bonaparte